Welcome back. It's time for Sunday Brunch, and joining us once again this morning is Erik Berlin, also known as Chef Egg, Cooking with Egg TV. Good morning.
How are you doing today?
Doing great. It smells so good. What is that?
Okay, we have some Irish-style bacon in honor of St. Patrick's Day today.
I didn't even know there was Irish bacon.
Absolutely. So what I have over here is the Irish butter, which we have right here, and we've got this Irish bacon, and it's sauteing together, and what we're going to make is a classic St. Patrick's Day dish called Col Canin.
Okay.
And what that is kale, cabbage, onions, sauteed in a little of that Irish butter, and then you smash up potatoes in there.
Okay, so you can buy the Irish bacon and
Absolutely.
The Irish butter.
Absolutely. So the difference between Irish bacon and regular bacon is that the regular bacon comes from the belly of the pig, where the Irish bacon comes from the loin, as you can see, the loin right here, and then that's a little bit of the belly right there. And it's more like a Sunday ham, more like a sliced ham, other than a fatty slice of bacon.
Yeah, because when I saw it, I thought it was Canadian bacon. So this little part here comes from the belly, and this is the loin part.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So it's more lean. You get more flavor. You'll see it as an Irish rashers or Irish bacon, but it's going to give us great smoky flavor for this dish over here. And the reason I'm doing this dish is not a lot of people like cabbage.
And corned beef.
Well, you know, they boil it for hours and hours. It does get the corned beef nice and tender, but it makes the cabbage super mushy.
Yeah.
And also cooks out all the nutrition. So what we have over here is some cabbage, some kale, and some onions. And we're going to throw that in our pan, and we're going to simply saute this for, I don't know, maybe 5-10 minutes until it's soft, and then you can you know, season it with a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper, and you've got a great cabbage side for your St. Patrick's Day celebration. A little Guinness, a little Jameson's, I don't know. Well, how do you feel about the Guinness and the Jameson's? Are you in?
I think it's fine. I take mine with a Chardonnay, but that's
okay.
Okay,
sure, sure, absolutely.
So then what do you do with the potatoes?
Okay, so once this has softened up, you take these boiled potatoes, you throw them right in, and you mash them right into the greens.
No way, okay, so then it just kind of gives it that whole mixed up flavor.
Absolutely.
There.
And again, the less you cook this, the better it is. The more nutrition you have, and I think the more character and the more flavor you have in this as well.
You're doing an Irish cooking class coming
Absolutely,
up.
Yes. We've got an Irish cooking class at the Blue Moon Cafe on Thursday at 7:15. It's BYOB, so you can bring out your Jamesons and your Guinness.
There you go.
And we're doing this. We're doing the shepherd's pie we made earlier, and we're actually making an Irish milkshake that has Jamesons and Guinness right in it.
That sounds very, very decadent.
Absolutely.
And this is something you do quite often, though. This is,
oh, yeah.
This is what you do. You teach people how to cook in your TV show, and you have something new in the works
for that. Yes. We just did an Indiegogo crowdfunding campaign for Chef Egg's Cooking Experience.
Awesome.
And what it is a television show that brings the world, brings the kitchen to life through different characters and different points of view about the kitchen.
Because you want people to be excited about
cooking. Absolutely. And it's going to be a cooking show for the whole family to watch together, the first of its kind.
All right. I can't wait to see that. That sounds so exciting. We want to let people know, if you'd like a copy of today's recipe, just log on to our website, WBALTV.com, click on food, or you can send us a self-addressed stamped envelope to Sunday Brunch, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211.